Who are you?
Mr. Abrams. I'm Robert Paige. They told me I should talk to you.
About what?
Well, you're Mr. Abrams, right?
Yes, I'm John Abrams. What of it?
Well, you see, sir, I'm new here, and I heard that you needed a new assistant.
Typewriter?
Well, yes, sir.
You know how to use it?
Yes, sir.
Finish high school?
Of course, sir.
You're hired. Start tomorrow, 8 a.m. sharp. Come in. Come in. You're late.
Oh, I'm so sorry, sir. I swore it was 10 of 8.
I'm just joking with you, kid. Have a seat.
Would you mind if I put this?
So, Paige, where are you from?
Oh, I'm from Philadelphia.
What are you doing in a place like Shady Grove?
Well, you know, they say the best start a newspaper man can have is in a small town.
Is that so?
Yes, sir. They say that the best place to learn the basics is in a small town.
They? Who the hell is they? Don't listen to them. They don't know what they're talking about.
Oh.
Don't worry, kid. I'll show you the ropes.
Thank you, sir. Oh, and by the way, you can call me Robert.
Robert Paige, that has a nice ring to it.
Why did you hire me so, I don't know, so abruptly?
My last assistant, he disappeared very recently.
Well, what if he came back?
I don't know about that, Robert. Once people find their way out of this town, they usually don't find their way back.
Right. Well, look, I really appreciate you giving me this job, and I hope that I'm confident that my work will be substantial and it'll...
Yeah, kid. Let's get cracking. Here's your first assignment. The geese overtaking the pond.
And I know it sounds crazy, but I think the lake might just dry up.
Okay, now, tell me how you think the drought would affect your life in the future.
Well, you probably couldn't swim in the lake much. And Pop probably couldn't go fishing anymore, neither. Do you think?
No, I guess not. All right. I'd like to thank you again for letting me interview you. Can I get your name?
Caroline Potter. That's 2 T's.
Okay. Thank you, Miss Potter.
Thank you, Mr.
Paige. Robert Paige.
Heading back? So, kid, how'd it go?
Well, you know, I guess it went okay. You know, I asked a few questions, got a few opinions, you know, pretty calm. I was wondering if, you know, if you might give me some heavier assignments.
Heavier assignments?
I mean, like, I've been here for a few weeks already, and
this is Shady Grove.
Yes, I know, but it's just that I'd be
happy that so far you've had something to write about.
Oh, I am grateful, sir, I am.
You think my columns are any more interesting? You'll learn your basics. I just don't want you looking down on this operation.
I don't, sir.
This is more important a job than any. The people rely on us to deliver, and it's our job to do just that. That should be your rule number one as a newsman. You must always deliver. Got it?
You must always deliver. Yes, I got it.
Then if you can't do that, well, then you're out of the job.
Oh.
I'm not trying to scare you. It's just the way it works.
Right, I understand. Mr. Abrams, what the hell are we gonna do?
What? You've never heard of this before?
No.
We call it reporter's block.
That's very nice, Mr. Abrams. But we're out of the job, just like you said.
Calm down, kid.
Wait. This has happened before?
It hasn't happened in a while, but it happens to the best of us.
I don't think a blank front page happens to the best.
Don't question my status as an editor, Mr. Paige. I'll replace you so fast.
I apologize, sir. Where are we going?
Paige, if you didn't sit on one ass cheek the entire ride, I bet you'd have a lot better attitude.
Answer my question.
Where are we going?
Yes.
I'm really not sure. We're looking for news.
Yeah, but what about
What's rule number one?
You must always deliver.
You must always deliver. It's a good rule. I like that one. Give me the gun.
Mr. Abrams,
Give me the gun.
Mr. Abrams, where are we going?
Good afternoon, Bill!
Good afternoon, Mr. Abrams. Going hunting?
Couldn't have said it better myself. Is he dead?
Yes, I think so.
Well, there's your story, kid. I'm giving it to you because you're the rookie here. Give me a nice lead, like Bill Hickman, murdered by person or persons unknown.
Mr. Abrams, you can't... You do realize
Shut
that
your
you...
mouth and take some goddamn notation. Well, that's that.
What?
I said, let's go.
Look, sir, I'm sorry, but I'm not gonna
ask. Listen, Mr. Paige, if you don't stop your whining, I'm gonna send you back to Philadelphia, a poor, inexperienced reporter. Now, you wanted to learn the basics.
This is not the basics. This is...
Murder?
Yes!
How's it gonna go? Editor's assistant murders innocent bystander. That has a nice ring to it.
Me?
Yes, you. You think I take the fall?
You're the one who did it!
The truth isn't what counts. It's the facts.
And the facts prove that,
that
you...
I did it? But what's my motive? That I wanted to get a good news story? Who'd buy that? It's your word over mine. And besides, it's your fingerprints on the gun. What about murder on a dirt road? Sounds catchy, doesn't it? You interview the family tonight, and I'll write an editorial tomorrow. Oh, what a beautiful day.
What?
I'm kidding, kid. It's just me.
Scare me half to death. Don't do that. How can I help you?
Just wanted to see how you were doing, kid.
I really don't know how I'm doing.
Well, I must say you're doing relatively well. I'm proud of you, Robbie. This whole story has lost its momentum anyway. You won't have to write much more about it. I decided not to go through with the investigation of the suspects. Didn't feel right.
Oh, thank you, sir. That's a relief.
Well,
what?
What? I didn't say anything.
Oh. It's nothing. Where are you going?
think I'm gonna go find something for the Gazette.
Something?
Something. I'm not sure what it is yet, but I know we need something.
Oh.
I'll be back in an hour. Your help.
You do?
You know there's something out there. We just gotta look and I think we can find it.
I really...
Fine. I'll go myself. Why don't you try to find something here?
I'll go.
You will? Alright. Let's get cracking. Grab your coat. What time is it?
It's quarter after two.
Damn.
Hey, there's that girl I interviewed
yesterday. Get down.
What?
I said, get down.
Sir.
Early start?
Yes, sir.
Well, that's good to see. Really shows me that you're starting to have what it takes.
Really, sir?
Yep. Let's see. Let's get correct. Well, Robbie, looks like we reached another impasse. Looks like we're gonna have to go out and find some news.
No, wait, sir. I think I have something here.
Attaboy. Give it to me when you're done with it.
Yes, sir.
You know, Robbie, you're turning out to be a swell newspaper man.
Well, thank you, sir.